This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to do some simple interest problems where we have to find either the principal or the rate or the time. So here's the first problem. This says, an investment earned $11.25 interest after 9 months. The rate was 5%. What was the principal? Okay, so we're going to start out with the basic formula for simple interest. That's interest equals the principal times the rate times the time. And we'll fill in whatever we know about this problem. So we know the interest. That was $11.25. We're looking for the principal, so we'll just leave that as P. We know the rate was 5%. I'm going to write the rate as a decimal, 0.05. And the time was 9 months. So since we normally think of time in these kind of simple interest problems in terms of years, what we're dealing with is 9 months out of a 12-month year, or 9 over 12. We could reduce that to 3 over 4, but I think easiest would be to work with that as a decimal. So let's take that 3/4 and make it into 0.75. Okay, so now what we've got is 11.25, that was the interest, equals the principal times 0.05, that's the rate, times 0.75, which is the time. And now we just have to solve for P. So I'm going to start out by dividing both sides of the equation by 0.05. If I divide 11.25 by 0.05, we're going to find that equals 225. And so that is 225 equals P times, I've still got this 0.75. So now we'll just divide both sides of the equation by 0.75. The right side of the equation is going to just be P. And 225 divided by 0.75, if we use a calculator for that, we find out it equals 300. Okay, so the principal equals $300. Here's the next one. This says $2,000 was invested for 3 years. It earned $204 in interest. What was the rate? Okay. So here's our basic formula. Interest equals principal times rate times time. We know the interest. That was 204. We know the principal this time. That's the $2,000 that was invested. We're looking for the rate, so we'll just leave that as R. And we know the time. The time is 3 years. So we want to find out what the R is. I'm going to start out by dividing both sides of the equation by 3. 204 divided by 3 is 68. So I've got 68 equals 2,000 times R. And then I just divide both sides of the equation by 2,000. I'll have just the R on the right side, and 68 divided by 2,000 is 0.034. So this is the rate. Now, since rates are normally stated as a percent, we probably want to turn this 0.034 into a percent. I'll do that by multiplying it by 100, that's 3.4, and adding a percent sign. So the rate equals 3.4%. And here's the last one. In this one, we're looking for the time, the length of a loan. So it says a loan of $1,200 had $36 in interest. The rate was 6%. What was the length of the loan? So So there's our basic formula, I equals PRT. The interest is $36. That equals the principal, that was $1,200, times the rate, we've got that also, that's 6%. I'll write that as a decimal, 0.06, and that's times the length of the loan, the time, which is what we're looking for. So I'm going to start this one by dividing by 0.06. 36 divided by 0.06 is 600. So I've got 600 equals 1200 T. Next, I just divide both sides by 1200. I can reduce that down. Let's just reduce that to 1/2. So T equals 1/2. So this is 1/2 year. When we're dealing with less than a year, very often we'll change that into months. So if a year is 12 months, a half a year is 6 months. So the time equals 6 months. Okay, that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.